Good evening, everyone. This is Pastor Jim Cimbala, and it's New Year's Eve, the 31st of December, the year of our Lord, 2020. We will not soon forget 2020, will we? No, what a year. What a year. So what we have for you is praise and worship and the choir singing exactly as they did in the second service last year on New Year's Eve. There was nothing else to do in my heart and my mind except to capture the anticipation, the joy, the worship, the praise of what happened last year as we look to the Lord for grace to get through 2020. And was the Lord not faithful? Here I am talking, you're alive, you're listening, and we're still trusting Jesus and praising God. So I trust you'll enjoy this replication of the meeting, the exact meeting that we had at 10 o'clock on December 31st, 2019. You know, I want to make you aware that we are watching every single week and month what's happening in New York in terms of shutdowns and COVID protocols, so that we can look for the day when we can meet together again the way we want to. Oh, we're going to have a day that day. Right now, we're thinking of just starting at 9 o'clock and going through to 3 o'clock. People can come, go, stay the whole day. Some people have told me on the phone, Pastor, I'm not leaving that day. I'm not coming for just one service. And we'll just have the choir sing the word, praise, thanksgiving, testimonies. We're just going to just tear that place up as we worship the Lord together. So we're waiting and watching for that, and we'll keep you updated on our plans. But right now, let's go back 1 year exactly, December 31st, 2019. And when it's over that part, you're going to get back to me, and I have a word for you here as we enter the year 2021. God bless you.
Good evening. Happy New Year. Is anybody ready to praise the Lord tonight? We're going to end this year the right way, by doing what we were created to do, by lifting up the name of Jesus. Amen? Come on, let's all sing. Jesus, we lift your name.
Jesus, we lift your name. Jesus, we lift your name on high. Your name on high, we lift it high. Jesus, we lift your name on high. Your name on high, we lift it high. Jesus, we lift your name on high. Your name on high, we lift it high. We lift it high. We lift it high. We lift it high. Your name be glorified, be glorified, be lifted high. Jesus, your name be glorified, be glorified. Sing that again. Oh, Jesus, your name be glorified, be glorified, be lifted high. Jesus, your name. Lift it high, lift it high, lift it high.
Come on, let's sing that with him. Let's sing, oh. Bless the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Let's just thank the Lord right now for all that he's done for us this year. Thankful for your faithfulness, Jesus. You've been a good, good father to us, oh God. Tonight we worship you in spirit and in truth. We lift our hearts to you in praise and adoration. Hallelujah. Let's all sing. I want to be close.
I want to be close, close to your side. So heaven is real, and death is a lie. I want to hear voices of angels above.
Singing hallelujah, holy, holy God. Bless your name right now in this church, oh Jesus. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. We adore you tonight, Jesus. When we look back over this year, think of all the things that you've done for us, the ways that you've been faithful. We're overwhelmed with worship, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, let's all lift our voices and sing, holy.
Oh,
Let's all lift our hands across the room. Sing holy.
While the band plays, let's just not sing. Just lift your voice and praise the Lord for all he's done in 2019. Can you do that in English or Spanish? In Creole, we praise you. We thank you. We're not ashamed to lift our voice in the great congregation. Gracias, Señor. Gracias, Señor. We praise you and we thank you, Lord. We love you. We appreciate you, Lord. Your mercies are new every day. Great is your faithfulness. Receive our praise, Lord. On this last couple hours of the year, Lord, receive our praise, Lord. Come on, to finish it off, let's all lift our hands. Everybody in the building, lift your hands and sing, holy, you are holy. Santo Señor, Santo Señor, Santo. Santo Señor, we praise you, we love you, we adore you, we bless your name. God, you are mighty. We worship your power and your holiness, Lord. God, like you. Last line. Can we give them a land of the year hand clap of praise? We praise you, Lord. We praise you. We praise you. We celebrate you. We bless you, Lord.
slipping away. Economy's down, they can't get enough hay. As for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Out in the streets, and the drug habits, some say they just can't beat. Muggers and robbers, no place seems to be safe. But you've been my protection every step of the way, and I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Hey, 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 it could have been.
And someone who would care. When I think of how far I had wandered, wounded and filled with shame, I stand amazed that He loved me before. I've heard
We worship you, Lord. How great is our God?
How great, Lord, you are.
Lift up one hand, everyone lift up one hand and sing our How Great Is Our God.
How great,
we worship you, Lord. Gloria a tu nombre, Señor.
Praise the Lord. Before I open God's word, I just want to remind you, although the church is shut down this week, New Year's Eve week, we're opening up again in terms of receiving your phone calls. You can always go to the website, brooklyntabernacle.org, and learn what's happening now in the new year. What's going to be happening? Well, the main thing is, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 5, 6, 7, and 8 of January, we're having a week of prayer. That's right, a week of prayer done virtually. You're going to hear from the pastors. You're going to hear words of encouragement. And then each night, we're going to be able to take time and in an inspired way, hopefully, from the Word of God and by the Spirit of God, we're going to take time to wait on the Lord, pray, meditate, thank, praise, listen, intercede, supplicate, bring our burdens to the Lord and leave them there. So remember that next week. That'll be having a January 3rd service, obviously, in a couple of days from now, but then 5, 6, 7, and 8. Every single night at, I guess, 7 or 8 o'clock, it'll go on. And you'll be able to enjoy it as if we were together, the best we can do. Also remember that I thank you for all your faithful giving. Oh, we are ending, I want to declare to you, we are ending 2020. And someone said to me the other day, I'm not going to say goodbye to 2020. I'm going to say good riddance 2020. What a difficult year. But all things work together for good to them that love God. So God's purposes are being worked out no matter what's going on around us. As we finish this year, I want to declare to you, the bills are up to date and paid. We got a couple little things. We're facing some big time repairs on the roof. You don't want to know those numbers coming at us in the new year. Some other things laying before us, but we're ending the good year, the year on a good note. And God has been so faithful, and He's worked through you. So everybody watching this, I want to say thank you for your faithful giving. And you can go to the website should you want to give some more here. Right here on the last night of the year, and going into the new year, you'll know how to make your donations so the work of the Lord can be continued. Not one missionary missed a support check. Since March, when we were forced to shut down, all the way to now. Praise God, praise God, praise God. We praise God. So now I want to leave you just with a brief thought. No lengthy sermon, but a thought. To end the new year, begin, end the old year, begin the new year. And it's found in the book of Ephesians, and it's something strange. I don't know of any other passage like this, because what God is saying to us here through the Apostle Paul, who is writing to the church at Ephesus, he's writing and he's saying to them, you know, I really hope you get to know something that you can never get to know. You know, it's like going to school and having the professor say, we're going to study this. Of course, we'll never know this, but let's study it anyway. So this is a profound, profound, the deepest thought about God. And although unknowable fully, listen to what Paul says. And I pray, Ephesians 3, verse 17, and I pray. He's in the middle of a prayer. And now we're finding out what he feels is important for the people he loves so much. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge. I want you to know something that surpasses knowing. But let's dig in anyway and pray that God will reveal it to us. Why? So that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. For the last month or so, I have been overwhelmed on a daily basis just about, and at some moments in a very profound way, with the vastness of God's love. Not what I do for God, not what you do for God, but the very nature of God being his essence is love. God has power, but he's not power. Those are attributes. God has knowledge. He's omniscient. He knows all things, but he isn't knowledge. But the Bible here, in a way that we cannot fully comprehend, says that God is love. And Paul says it's important if we're going to grow, if we're going to be victorious, if we're going to be blessed the way God wants us to be blessed, if we're going to radiate what God wants us to radiate, that saltness, saltiness and light, with the light of the world, we have to be dwelling this coming year now, every day, every single day, on the fact that God is love. How great is his love? Go in the back of your Bible like I have here. This is not a big fancy study Bible, but it has a concordance in the back. And just go to the word love. And look all the times love is used, specifically not in the case of a command, love one another, even as I have loved you, and love used that way, but about God, about the love of God. God is love, so I want you to remember that God is, of course, eternal. So we learn over and over again in the Bible that God's love endures forever. I think it's Psalm 136 that has verse after verse, and you did this and you did that, and his love endures forever. And then he opened the Red Sea, his love endures forever. And he supplied for us, and he did this for us, his love endures forever. His love endures forever, just repeated over and over again. So I want you to know this and ponder it. This unknowable love has no end. Because God has no end, and God is love. You know how some people like you for a while, And then they're like, hey, I'm over that. I'm over you. I'm so over you. I'm so done with that. God is never done with anyone. His love endures forever. Why? Because God is eternal, and since his essence is love, that love is eternal. God, as I said before, is omniscient. So it's good to remember that he knows everything, and yet his love endures forever. Isn't it wonderful to know that God knows everything we've ever done, and it doesn't even alter his love for us? Who is a God like this? He knows every bad secret about you and me, everything we've ever done or said in the heat of passion, anger, bad words, things we've done, dishonest things we've said, lies we've told. He knows all of that, and his arms still go out to us in total love. That's no love that we know here on earth, except maybe sometimes with a devoted parent along those lines. His love is unchanging. Doesn't matter what you and I have done or will do in the future. He knows all about that too. And he says, I love you with an everlasting love. Oh, praise be to God. Wouldn't it be nice if we all woke up tomorrow morning on January 1 and then every day in 2021 and we just focused before we even got out of the bed. God, thank you for loving me. Thank you for loving me. Satan will battle you on that. Nah, God doesn't love you. He used to love you. Now look what's going on in your life. How could that be love? But we got to stand on God's word no matter how we feel or what we see happening around us. God's love is unchanging and eternal. His very essence versus his attributes is love. As I said before, he has attributes. He is everywhere at the same time, omnipresent. But his essence is love. He is love. His love can't be comprehended. As the writer here says, it's unknowable. But let's do a little searching, shall we, biblically? He says, I wish you could understand. I pray that God would open your understanding so you could know, number one, how high God's love is. I want to tell you on this New Year's Eve, God's love. Go and get a picture from the most powerful telescope that we now have. It's looking into things that no one ever dreamed of, the vastness of the universe. Not just us and the sun 93 million miles away and the moon and the stars we see, but, you know, whole galaxies of space so high up there. God's love is higher than all of that. When you look up in the sky tomorrow, and whether it's day and you see the sun or night and you see the moon, and you look up, you see stars. Just every time we look up, oh God, help us. Every time we look up to be reminded, that's how big my love is for you. That's how I cherish you. God is saying to us, I want you to live in that. Remain in my love. Be conscious of my love. Depend on my love. And by the way, that's how we love him back. We love him because he first loved us. It's an awareness and conviction, an experience of God's love that causes us to love back. So when you find your love flagging and kind of petering out, don't try to love God more. Just contemplate his love. Read about his love. It's so high. And how low is it? I wish you could know the depth, Paul says. How low is it? His love is so low and goes to such depths that he gave up his only son when you and I were not even born. He gave his son up. And if you were the only human on the earth, he would have given Jesus up just for you, just for me. What kind of love is that? Not just to come to earth, but to become a man and empty himself of the glory that he had in heaven, to become tired and poor and hungry and thirsty, to cry, to get beat, to get killed on a cross so our sins can be forgiven. He did that for you and I before we were born. So this love is unearned. It is God's essence. We didn't do something to get that love. Here on earth, the way it is, you do for me, I do for you. Or you can say, I had someone say, I was counseling a few years ago, you know, I when I met him, I didn't fall in love with him immediately, but the way he acted toward me, his kindness toward me, he won my heart. We did nothing to win God's heart. And we can do nothing to make God stop loving us. He might weep over us, but not stop loving us. Oh, how deep is that love? In another sense, it's deep. You can't go so low that you're too deep for God's love to scoop you out. Over all the years that my wife and I have been in the ministry at the Brooklyn Tabernacle, can I give you testimony after testimony of people we have baptized who have come to faith in Jesus Christ, and their testimonies are, oh, I was so low, but he reached down his hand for me. I hated myself. I was involved in animalistic behavior. But he didn't turn away and go, oh, you're repugnant. No, that love. Oh, that love of God. Can't you rejoice in that love of God that has us praising him here on New Year's Eve? Oh, how deep it goes. No pit is so deep, Corrie Ten Boom said, that God's love is not deeper still. No, so if the enemy's lying to you and saying, nah, nah, not after what you did, no one else might know about it, but I know what you did, you just resist that demonic thought and rest in God's love. No one knows the height. No one knows the depth. I've been listening lately, if you want to hear a good song, for the lyrics, the melody, whether you like it or not, is irrelevant. There's a famous Christian song called, it's like a hymn now, The Love of God. I don't know who wrote that, but the words of the second verse, I believe it is, are, I've never heard any words like that. I can't give it to you exactly, I think, with the rhyme, but it goes, could we with ink the oceans fill? All the oceans, Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, all the oceans, fill it all with ink. Could we with ink the oceans fill? And every stalk, every blade of grass, every branch, everything, every stalk on earth, a quill, a writing instrument that you dip into ink. And if all the sky of parchment made, all the skies, all the everything in the universe that's up there, the whole atmosphere was made of parchment. So now you got everything is a quill, the oceans are filled with ink, all the sky is a parchment, and every man a scribe by trade, someone who copies things and writes. Even with that, the song says, you couldn't write on all the heavens, with all the ink, with all the atmosphere, with all the universe, you couldn't write how deep the love of God is. The love of God, how rich, how full, how measureless and strong. It shall forevermore endure. Oh, that love of God. Let's live in that. Let's live in that. Let's rejoice in the fact God loves me. Someone turned on you in 2020. Whatever happened to you, guess what? God loves me. And God is for you. And God is with you. And you know, how wide is it? Let me close with that. How wide is it? It's so wide it reaches every human. Every black person, every white person. Every Latino, every tribe, every language, everybody, God loves them. They might resist that love and end up going into eternity away from God, but it won't be because God didn't love and offer them salvation or show them some light to respond to. That's how wide it is. And that's a good reminder as we go into a year that will be filled with more hate than 2020, because the society is getting now more hate-filled. You know, people of other races, God loves them. And if you're angry with them or prejudiced against them, you now have a problem with God, because now you're touching someone God loves. You're talking nasty about someone God loves. God loves Republicans, Democrats, liberals, conservatives. God loves everybody. We got to be careful. I'm telling you, we live in a society now, we only love people who agree with us. If you don't, you're a devil. God loves everyone. And you know how I am. I love my children so much. Somebody is mean to one of my children, you're going to get a reaction from me. It's not going to be like nice. I don't want God to be, his spirit grieved and quenched because I'm acting mean to people he loves. Love your enemies. Bless those that curse you. We're into a now cultural Christianity where I'm not even sure it resembles hardly at all the beautiful Christianity of the Bible. Ours is based on cultural, political, racial factors. But God's love, it goes so wide. People who disagree with you and me, God loves them. Imagine that. They disagree with Jim Cimbala and God loves them. I mean, God, don't you know what you're doing? I'm the center of the universe. Someone disagrees with me, doesn't like me. How could you possibly love them? Oh, the love of God. How wide, how deep. And that's why, as I close, Paul says a little later on in this same letter, follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in love. Walk in the way of love. Or as 1 Corinthians 16:14 has it, and I love this short NIV version of that verse, do everything in love. Because God loves us so much, and I'm here because of his love, I'm going to be hateful and mean to people this year? No, God forbid, for all of us. Let's walk in love. Last thing here, this essence of God is communicable. The theologians call it a communicable attribute or part of who God is. Now, only in part, we're never going to love with his love, but he imparts his love into our hearts. He doesn't communicate to us his omnipresence so that I can be everywhere at once. He says, no, you just stay right where you are. Just be where you are. But my love, if you ask me and trust me, I'll fill you with my spirit, who is love. And the fruit of the spirit is love. So in a world getting more hateful and dark by the day, entering into even religion, Christianity so-called, let's stand out this year for two reasons. We're every day dwelling on the love of God. Study it. Ask God to enlighten you on it. You trust me, no matter how deep you go, you'll go, wow, I haven't even, you know, I've scratched the surface of how deep that love is. And let's share that love. Let's live in love. Lord, we thank you that you got us through 2020. And with everything swirling around us, we pray today that we will focus daily on how much you love us. God is love. Help us to understand by revelation of the Holy Spirit from the Word of God just how deep that love is, how high, how wide, how vast, how strong. Your love endures forever. and fill us with your love so that our mouths speak words filled with grace and love. Take away from us hate, prejudice, anger, wrath, nastiness, testiness, moodiness, and help us to be like Jesus. We pray this in his name. Amen. Well, we're not having the countdown, but whenever you're watching this, from the staff of the Brooklyn Tabernacle, from my wife Carol and I, Happy New Year. God bless you.